Welcome to our celebration. We have gathered here for a joyous celebration of a holy season leading up to a holy night, the night of our Savior's birth. We are here tonight not only to decorate our church, but to once again tell the story of God's Son coming to earth. It was a night of divine wonder, but most of all, it was a night of hope. God gave his only begotten Son to a world in need of celebration, of hope. Today is the first Sunday of Advent. Advent is a time of preparation and waiting, a time for decorating our homes and church in celebration of Jesus' birth. We light the candle of hope. It reminds us of the hope we have in the return of Christ. Romans 15:13 says, "May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit." Please remain seated as we sing "Joy to the World" and light the Advent candle. The lyrics are printed in your bulletin. As we prepare to decorate our sanctuary for the Christmas season, let us reflect the meaning of the decorations we use. The poinsettia is a popular flower for Christmas decorating. The star-shaped formation of vibrant red leaves symbolizes the Star of Bethlehem and the blood of Christ. The poinsettias around our church have been placed in memory and honor of our loved ones. The most universal decoration of Christmas is the evergreen. Evergreen and ever alive, even in the winter months. Ancient Romans considered evergreens as an emblem of peace, joy, and victory. The early Christians placed them in their windows to indicate that Christ had entered the home. The constant green reminds us of God's constant love. The evergreen wreaths are a never-ending circle, just as the never-ending love from God. Remain seated as we sing "Deck the Halls," printed in your bulletin.
Thank you.
Let our green Christ Jesus. We now invite children and adults who would like to hang an ornament on the tree to come forward as we sing O Christmas Tree.
This evening will 100% be given to the Martinsburg Food Pantry, I believe is what I read. We do our offering a little differently at Clover Creek. I don't know if you noticed when you came in, the offering plates were out there. So in a little while, we'll be asking that to come forward. Just some thoughts about it, you know, to share with those in need in our community. It's just but one way that we can reflect the love of Jesus Christ. I'm sure that in your creative ways, you all can figure out other ways that you can share Christ's love this Christmas season. And with that being said, I'd like to ask the ushers to please bring our offering forward.
Thank you.
Gracious Father, you loved the world so much that you gave your only begotten Son. We thank you, Lord, for showing us that to love is to give. Accept our gifts and bless others in your love. Amen.
The birth of the king was not as expected, but rather, Jesus was born in a common stable surrounded by animals. The birth of Jesus comes from the book of Luke, chapter 2. The angels, the messengers of God, have always been a part of the history of mankind. It was the angel Gabriel who was sent by God to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin named Mary. She was engaged to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. Gabriel said to Mary, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and shall call him named Jesus. He will be great, and he will be the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. and of his kingdom there will be no end. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken. So Joseph and Mary went up to the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, to the town of David. There was no room in the inn, so the best they could find was a stable behind the inn. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and Mary gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling cloth, and laid him in a manger. Events immediately following Jesus' birth are exciting indeed. Luke chapter 2 records one event that forever changed the life of several shepherd boys. He writes, "And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And the angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were very afraid. The angel said unto them, Fear not. For behold, I bring you good news of a great joy, which will come to all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. Can you imagine the shepherds' excitement as they frantically ran to see this one of whom the angels had told them? Can you imagine their awe as they looked up upon the faces of Jesus for the first time? Can you sense their deep gratitude that God would make his presence known to them so that they too could worship the one who came to save the world? Please remain seated as we sing the first and second verse of the first Noel. There were wise men from the east. They saw the star which announced the birth of Jesus. They set out on a journey traveling across the desert to visit this newborn child. Matthew 2:11 says, "On to the coming house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh." Gold reminds us that Jesus is truly King of Kings. Frankincense was the gift for a priest. Jesus is our only high priest. Myrrh was an unusual gift for a newborn because myrrh was given to those who were dying. From the beginning, Jesus' life had but one purpose, to die for the sins of mankind. Please remain seated as we sing verses 3, 4, and 5 of the First Noel. Christmas is a remembrance and a celebration of the holy night long ago when the Savior brought hope and joy into our world. He didn't remain a baby in the manger, but he grew to be a man, and his light is now shining in our lives. As love lights our hearts, the chains of sin are broken. In the light of his love, oppression ceases, and only in the light of his love can we truly love one another. But we accept his love and live in its light as he has taught us. That is why we gathered here tonight. We must rejoice and be glad, for he is the light and we have received that light. Thus, we end where we began, in celebration. Please remain seated and the angels will light our candles. Please tilt your unlit candle toward the lit candle.
stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope the weary soul rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices, oh, night divine, oh, night when Christ was born, oh, night divine, oh, night, oh, night divine. Led by the light of faith serenely beaming, with glowing hearts by his cradle we stand. So led by light of a star sweetly gleaming, here came the wise men from Orient land. The King of Kings lay thus in lowly manger, in all our trials born to be our friend. He knows our need, our weakness is no stranger. Behold your King, before him lowly bend. Behold your King, before him lowly bend. Truly he taught us to love one another. His law is love, and his gospel is peace. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise his holy name. Christ is the Lord, oh, praise his name forever. His power and glory evermore proclaim. His power and glory forevermore proclaim.
a dark world, we are called to be carriers of God's light. We light our candles as reminders to shine our lights. Make us ready, O God, for the coming of Jesus, our eternal light.